Learning AWS Cloud was one of the best decisions I've taken in my career. It changed my life completely. AWS is one of the leading cloud providers with the highest market segment. It helped me to grow exponentially in my career. So in this video, I will give you a complete guide on how you can learn AWS and increase your value in the market. I will give you a complete guide on how you can learn AWS from scratch. What are the top services you need to focus on as a data engineer? I will also guide you on how you can get certified, and at the end you will get 3 end-to-end projects on AWS so that you can understand the entire data engineering process easily. So in the first part of this video, we will talk about some of the top AWS services you need to focus on, and I will give you the good overview about these services, what they do and why do we need it as a data engineer. And in the second part of this video, we will talk about the certification and the projects related to AWS that you can do and put it in your resume. Now here's the thing, all of these cloud providers have more than hundreds of services available. The thing is, as a data engineer, you don't need to know all of these services. You just need to focus on some of the highly used services for data engineering and some of the fundamental services. So first, we will start by understanding what are the core services you need to focus on, and then we will talk about some of the certification path and how you can learn all of this. So number 10 on the list we have is Amazon S3. Simple storage service. Now, as a data engineer, you will be processing millions and billions of data. You need to store all of this data at some location. AWS S3 is your go-to place when you want to store all of these data. It is an object storage so that you can store any types of file you want, such as CSV, ORC, Parquet, JSON file, audio, video, whatever you want to store, you can easily store that on Amazon S3, and you can easily access all of these data using different services available on AWS. So in data engineering, we have a concept called as a data lake. It is a centralized repository where you store all of your data, and based on the requirement and the processing, you pick the right amount of data so that you can analyze it. Amazon S3 is the place where you build your data lake. After this, we have on the list is Amazon RDS. Relational Database Service. This service gives you access to different relational databases such as MySQL, PostgreSQL, Oracle, and Amazon's own database service, which is the Aurora. So in most of the cases, when you're installing all of these database server, you have to make sure you manage all of these things, update the software and the versions, and make sure all of these data scales as per the requirement. But if you use Amazon RDS, all of these things goes away. You just need to focus on managing your data and your application side. All of the other things such as backing up, security, making sure your database scales as per the requirement will be taken care by AWS itself. So you will be extracting a lot of these data from these databases, so you will have to use programming language, or you can use different types of tools so that you can extract all of this data and then load that data onto some storage. In general case, we use it S3 if you want to store all of this data. After that, we have the service called as AWS Glue. As a data engineer, you will be building a lot of data pipeline or writing ETL job, extract, transform, load. So the extraction part can be done using programming language. You can extract data from APIs, relational databases, or any other sources. After that, you have to write the transformation logic and load this data onto some location. To do this entire operation, we have a service called as AWS Glue, where you can easily write your ETL job and process your data on large scale. One of the best part about AWS Glue is that it is serverless. So when you're using AWS Glue, you don't really have to worry about the backend servers or the clusters or the machines. Everything will be taken care of by AWS itself. So as per your data volume and the size, it will automatically scale up and scale down. So this is one of the most important service as a data engineer you have to learn. After this, we also have EMR, Elastic MapReduce. So if you have heard about these technologies such as Hadoop, Spark, MapReduce, this particular service, the Elastic MapReduce, provides that kind of functionality. So the concept of distributed processing is that you can't process the large volume of data on your single machine. So what you do is you divide your data into multiple chunks and use multiple machines to process the chunks of the data, and then you combine the output at the end. Now, EMR is built for that. So when you want to process the huge volume of data and when you want to have a little bit control over the infrastructure side, then you can use this service EMR, where you can write your Spark job, where you can write your Hadoop jobs easily and process your data on large scale. After that, we have a service called as Amazon Athena. So if you have the basic understanding of the relational databases, you'll know that whenever we want to query our data, we have to use the language called as SQL. Now, in relational databases, we have to store all of these data in structured format. Then we can query all of these data. But what if we want to directly query on top of the existing files, such as CSV files or JSON files or Parquet files? You can directly query on top of the actual files using Amazon Athena. Then we have the service called as AWS Lambda. Whenever you want to run your code at specific events, such as, let's say, I want to run this particular code at 9 a.m. or I want to run this particular code whenever there is any file uploaded onto this particular S3 bucket. All of these things you can easily do that using AWS Lambda. So it is an event-based compute service. So whenever you want to trigger some part of the code based on some external events, then you can easily do that using AWS Lambda. Then we have the service called as the Amazon Redshift. The final goal of any data project is to help businesses to take data-driven decisions. The way businesses do that is by exploring and finding insights from the data. Now, Amazon Redshift is a data warehouse service provided by AWS, which is specifically designed for analytical workload. That means that if you want to analyze your data on large scale, for example, if you want to find the answer such as what was the last 5 years of revenue, how did we do this month compared to last 6 months, all of these answers you can easily find using SQL queries when you run on Amazon Redshift. After that, we have the service called as AWS Kinesis. Till now, all of the services that we talked about helps us to process our data in batches. But what if we want to process our data on real-time manner? This is the service. Amazon Kinesis can help you with that. AWS Kinesis has different components such as Firehose, Analytics. You can use these different components for specific kind of workloads and process your data in real-time manner. After that, we have the service called as the Amazon DynamoDB. Now, we were talking about the relational databases, but what if we want to store your data in unstructured format? Now, this is the service that provides the NoSQL database solution. If you want to build the high-performance application that can scale as per your user needs, this is the service that you will be using. Then we have the service called as a DMS, data migration service. So in my early career, I worked on a lot of migration projects. Migration projects mainly include going from on-premise network to the cloud platform. So you have your databases on your on-premise servers and you want to move them onto the cloud platform. Or if you want to migrate to, let's say, PostgreSQL to MySQL or Oracle DB to PostgreSQL, you can also do that. So AWS DMS, data migration service, is specially designed for these kind of workloads. So if you want to migrate your data from one system to another system, you can easily do that with just click of a button. Then we have many other services available such as AWS Step Function, AWS Batch, Manage Airflow Environment, IAM if you want to manage the identity and access, VPC if you want to work around the security. So all of these services are provided by AWS. These are the top services that you can focus on at the initial stage of your career if you want to grow as a data engineer. So these were the mainly the data services that you need to focus on. Now let's talk about how you can learn all of these different things, get started with the AWS and get certified, and finally build your project so that you can build your resume at the end. Now the first step I suggest people to do is go to the console.aws.com and create your account for free. Now this will give you access to AWS cloud for free for 12 months. So you can play around with the different services available on AWS. So initially what you need to do, you just need to get comfortable with the AWS UI and just play around the UI for a few hours. Once you get comfortable, then you can start exploring the AWS world by learning different parts of the services and get the overview about various services available on AWS. Now here's the gamified way of learning AWS. So you can go to the builder.aws.com. You will find plenty of resources to learn AWS. First exercise I suggest you to do is this one, AWS Cloud Quest Cloud Practitioner. This will give you the gamified experience of exploring various services available on AWS. So if you are very new and if you are a fresher in this field, then I will highly suggest you to do this lab. This is available for free. You just have to create your account and you can get started. This is one of the best resources if you want to learn the basics about the services and get overview of AWS cloud at the initial stage. So you can also explore other labs available on AWS Skill Builder. But once you do that, then I will highly suggest you to directly start preparing for the certification. Now the reason I'm telling you to prepare for the certification right away, because if you have some goal in your mind while you're learning, then you will be motivated to complete that. Certification is one of the best way if you want to learn anything, because you will have the goal at the end that I want to achieve this particular certification. So you will be preparing in that direction only. Now AWS provides multiple certifications that has the foundational certification, associate level certification, professional and specialty. So if you are planning to become a data engineer, then here's the path that you can take. So the first certification that you can prepare is AWS Cloud Practitioner. Now if you are completely new to AWS and if you have no idea about AWS, then this is the certification that you start with. This will give you the basic understanding of various services available on AWS, so you will get the good overview. Once you clear this exam, then you can jump onto the AWS Data Engineering Associate. Now this is the new certification that got uploaded recently, few months back. So if you are planning to become a data engineer, then this is one of the most important certification that you get. This certification gives you understanding about the various data engineering related workloads and services available on AWS. So all of these different services that we talked about in the phase one of this video, you will get the in-depth understanding and the working knowledge of these services. Once you get your associate level certification, then you have two choices. One is to go for the professional level certification, or you can go to the specialty level. Now, if you want to become an architect, or if you want to go on to more senior level and understand the architecture side of AWS, then I will suggest you to go with AWS Solution Architect Professional. This certification will give you in-depth understanding about various services available on AWS, and you will also learn how to build the overall architecture. If you are planning to do the specialty certification, then you can do the AWS database specialty. This certification will make you expert around the database technologies available on AWS. So this is the clear path how to get certified. Now, where to learn all of this? So if you are looking for the free resources, then you can go to the freecodecamp.org. This is available on YouTube for free. They have many different courses on these certifications. So what you can do, you can watch these videos and get started. You can also explore more different resources. So we also have the courses available on Coursera, Cloud Academy. Also on Udemy, you will find a bunch of courses. So I have created the Notion document and added all of these different resources in the description. So doing certification will give you understanding about various services available on AWS, and also give you the career boost, because you can mention all of these certification in your resume that will increase your value in the market. Now, this was just the learning part, but you also have to build up projects related to data engineering. Now, here are the three AWS projects. So the first project is the Spotify Data Pipeline. Now, this particular project is part of my Python for Data Engineering course. You will learn how to build a complete data pipeline using AWS. So we will extract data from the Spotify API. Then we will write some transformation jobs on AWS Lambda. Then we will store all of these data onto S3 bucket, do more transformation, use AWS Glue to build a catalog, and then use Amazon Athena to analyze all of these data. So this is the first project that I will suggest you to do. This is part of my courses, so you will find the link in the description if you're interested. Then the second project that is available for free on my YouTube channel called as the YouTube Data Analytics. This project has gotten more than 200k views. A lot of people have completed this project, and this is one of the best projects available out there on AWS Data Lake. So I will also recommend you to build this project. And then we also have the project called as a Twitter Data Pipeline using Apache Airflow. So here we also use the AWS services and Airflow. This project will teach you how to extract data from the API, do some basic transformation on Airflow, and deploy all of these code onto AWS EC2 machine. So doing these three projects will give you understanding of how data engineering projects are built onto AWS Cloud. And after this, you can start preparing for the interviews. Now, if you want the complete guide on how to prepare for data engineering interview and build your own portfolio, then you can watch this particular video. This video will give you the complete guide on how to prepare for data engineering interview. If you found this video helpful, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.